I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, we're looking at resizing photos to create enlargements. What's caught my attention is the recent release of Topaz Gigapixel. This software claims to use machine learning to improve your results when enlarging photos. The website makes a lot of comparisons with Photoshop, so I thought I'll run some of my own and let's test these comparisons to see what we get. The image we'll be using for the test is one that features a sunrise in the Highlands of Scotland that I shot recently. I captured it using a Fuji X-T3 and a Samyang 12mm prime lens. When we view this at 100%, you can see that it's packed with detail and the foreground is actually very sharp. Let's check the current size of the image. We move this to inches, we can see we have a 23 by 13 inch print at 240 pixels, which is quite large. Now this dialog also allows me to make the enlargements to the image. I'm going to do this by entering percentage increases. Now because I have this link here clicked, any enhancement I make to the width of the image is reflected in the height. So if I enter a 200% width increase, the height also increases by 200%, and you'll notice that the resolution of the image remains at 240. If we look further down, we have this resample option. Now when that's not ticked, what happens is that rather than create new pixels in the image, Photoshop readjusts this resolution. So if I just re-enter here, 200%, you can see that the resolution drops to 120 from 240. The pixels of the image have remained the same. All that's happened is we've halved the resolution. Let's just retick that and we'll reset this now to be 240. Now if you want to enlarge an image but keep the resolution the same, you need to have the resampled option ticked. When the resampled option's selected, we have access to different methods that Photoshop uses for the resampling. Now some of these methods are very old and probably well in excess of 20 years old, but they can be effective with different types of image. So if you were working with graphics, for example, the nearest neighbor method may be very effective, but it may not be well suited to photography. Let's select a very basic one, which is bilinear. Now, if we scale our image by 400%, we can get an idea of the results in this preview window. So I'm repositioning the preview window to look at a small area of the image here. And you can see it's making a reasonable job of resizing it, keeping the detail in the grass and the rock, but it's a little soft. If we now go to Preserve Details 2, which is a recent method of enlargement, you can see that this is a little bit sharper. An alternative new method of resizing was this Preserve Details. And when we select that, the image detail seems to be a little bit crisper. Now there's also an automatic option here. Now if I select that, what will happen is Photoshop tries to create the best enlargement based on what you're doing at the time. In this example, there wasn't any difference between the automatic and the preserved details enlargement in my preview. And that's because Photoshop decided that's the best routine to use, making a 400% increase in the size of this image. Now something to watch out for is that depending on what you're intending to do with the resized image, picking the option that gives the sharpest enlargement may not give you the best finished result. So don't be scared to try out some of the other options. Let's resize this image to 400%. Now the computer I'm using is a 2-year-old 27-inch Mac desktop. It's got an i7 processor and at the time it was the best spec you could purchase. As you can see, Photoshop's completed the resizing pretty quickly in this example. Let's come down and look at our detail. You can see it's quite sharp, viewed at 100%. Let's check the image size and we'll put this into inches, and you can see we've got a 93 inch by 53 inch print at 240 pixels per inch. Looking at what I'm seeing in the 100% magnification on screen, this would give a reasonably good print, and it would certainly be a huge print that you couldn't get too near to if you wanted to appreciate it. At this point, I wanted to show you the gigapixel processing of this image, but I can't for two reasons. Firstly, Gigapixel takes a long time to process the image, and I do mean a long time. Secondly, Gigapixel hogs all the resources on my computer, so I can't seem to do anything while it's running. Now that includes doing a screen recording, so as soon as it starts to process, the screen recording just seems to lock up. So what I've done is I've created a second test image, and it's cropped from this first image, which I've then saved as a TIFF file. Here's the image. You can see it's a section of the original. If I now fit that one to the screen, so we've taken a section from here, and that's it saved. Let's check the image size. And we've got 8.5 inches by 5.5 inches at 240 pixels. Let's resize that now to 400%. And I'm going to use the automatic option. The image looks reasonable when viewed at 100% magnification, looking at the same area. Let's check the image size. And we can see we've actually created a 35 by 23 inch image at 240 pixels, which is pretty good. If you're making a print from this, it should look okay from what we're seeing. Now, let's compare Topaz Gigapixel. With the image open in Topaz Gigapixel, what you get is this preview. And you can move the preview point around. Now at the moment I've got the scaling set to 4x or 400%. And looking at this preview, the original looks quite blurry, as you would expect, magnified to 400%. But the preview doesn't look particularly great. Now I've got to suppress noise at medium and also remove blur at medium. Now I'm wondering if this is part of the problem, and if I set this to none, and this to none, do we improve the results? It looks a little less sharp, but it's also looking a little bit blurry. It definitely seems to look better with the medium removed blur. I'm suspecting that this suppressing noise and removed blur is causing some sorts of problem in the preview. So I'm going to run it, but with these both off. The reason I've jumped back to Photoshop is because Gigapixel took 1:40 to actually process the image, and I didn't think it made for very good viewing. But what I have got open is a couple of images that I did process. The first one, which you can see on screen now, was processed in Gigapixel without any noise reduction or any blur reduction. Let's have a look at that at 100%. At first impressions, it looks very good. If I compare it to the test image that I had from Photoshop, you can see that actually it looks a little bit sharper. And it certainly appears to have more detail in there, so the claims they're making are actually pretty accurate. There is, though, something that I don't like too much. What Gigapixel appears to have done is, in some of the areas, such as here on the rock, you can see the details just a little bit soft. What we're seeing are slight artifacts here where it seems to have overcompensated on the edges and over sharpened them. it's then reached the sort of limit of what it can do to tighten up the blurry pixels. So where the pixels are soft, it started to try to overemphasize those, but then it's got to the point where it thinks, I can't do any more, and it stops processing them and just leaves it like the original. If we look back at the image here, you can see those areas are just that little bit softer on the Photoshop enlargement. On Gigapixel, they look a little bit better, but then you've got these artifacts around here. I did run the enlargement again, but I set the sharpness or the reduced blur to high, and this is what we get. Now again, it's not managed to fix these soft areas, and it has overemphasized around them. Where there is good detail though in the grasses, it's made a superb job of really pulling that out, and it's definitely better than the Photoshop Best, which actually now looks a little bit soft and blurry in comparison. Now I did try sharpening the Photoshop image, and it doesn't improve it to the level that we've got in Gigapixel. There definitely seems to be detail being pulled out in this. The question is, would you see these sharp edges in a print? Well, if I look at this at 100%, I would say, yeah, it would show up. But when you're printing, you don't tend to see 100% of the detail because the printer tends to soften edges to some extent. Let's look at it if it was at 50%. What we've got there is a really sharp image, and I can't see the artifacts anymore. Now, viewing the image at about 50% gives you a good impression of what the print would look like. So, although I'm concerned about these artifacts, the print should look pretty good. Now, I haven't tried printing this yet, and I will do in the future, but looking at what I'm seeing on screen, actually, it should make a pretty good print. And when you consider this is going to give me a 35-inch print, that's pretty good for a piece of software. So my conclusion, yes, I think Gigapixel can produce sharper enlargements with more detail than Photoshop can at the moment. But I am a little bit concerned about some of the artifacts I was seeing, and until I've printed this image, I'll remain concerned. I also think the processing time for Gigapixel is just unacceptable, and I think it does need to be sorted out. It needs to be faster and less resource hungry. Will this work for you? Is it better than Photoshop? I honestly don't know. I think it will depend on your images with your camera. And what I would say is, if you are interested in something like this, I would go and get the evaluation copy and try it out. I have been impressed by what it can do with my camera phone images, and it seems to perform well if you've not got any softer areas in your image as well. I hope you found that interesting. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.